Hey guys, in this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you how to change the color of this white shirt to any other color, including black. And you can apply this same method to other objects or clothes that you may have in your photos when editing. So stay tuned. The first step you need to do is to tell Photoshop what area do you want to affect with the color change. The way you do this is by creating a precise selection. In my case, I want to change the shirt of the model, and looks like I will need to create four separate selections. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I hit P for the pen tool, and then I slowly start to make points covering the areas that I want to affect. After the path is ready for the first area, I continue with the other three, and when all of them are done, I need to transform all these paths into selections. So after you finished using the pen tool, press Escape, and then with the pen tool still selected, right-click and choose Make Selection. This will allow you to choose a feather value. And I want it to be at 0 for all these selections because I want to have sharp edges for my selection. Press OK, and now the paths disappeared and you have some precise selections. In case anything goes wrong and you accidentally deselect, you can always go to this tab called Paths. You can click once to reveal the paths created with the pen tool, or you can hold down Ctrl and click on the thumbnail here to reactivate the selections. If you don't see this tab, you can activate it by going to Window, Paths. Another way to convert all the paths at once into selections is to hold down Ctrl plus Enter, and all the paths created using the pen tool will transform into selections. However, you will not get the chance to choose the feather value this time because that small window will not show up anymore. So it's up to you which option you choose to make selections. There are plenty of ways to do that. Okay, now that I have the selection of the shirt, I will make a solid color adjustment layer. Let's say I choose a nice blue here, and then when I hit OK, my selection will transform into a layer mask, which is awesome. The next step is to put this layer on Multiply Blending Mode. And this is starting to look much better now, as you can see. So this will be the layer that will allow me to change this color anytime that I want. I just double-click, choose a yellow or an orange color, hit OK, and there you have it. But this is not all because I want to make it look more realistic. You see, even if I choose a vibrant color, it doesn't look that vibrant on the shirt. So I need to control the brightness and the contrast of this color. I found that the easiest adjustment layer to choose is the brightness and contrast. You can use curves or levels, but you need to understand those tools first. They are more complex. So if you want the easiest option, just add this brightness and contrast layer on top of the solid color adjustment layer. The problem is that when I start moving the brightness slider, it will affect the whole image, and I don't want that. I want to affect only the shirt, or in other words, I want to use the same layer mask like for this layer. So the easiest way to handle it is this. Instead of creating a duplicated layer mask, I will select this layer, hold Ctrl, and select the other layer, and with both layers selected, I create a group by clicking on this icon right here or by pressing Ctrl plus G. Okay, so now I have a group, and what you need to know is that a group can have its own layer mask that will affect all the layers inside that group. I will drag the layer mask of the solid color adjustment layer and move it on the group itself just by using drag and drop. This layer mask will affect both the brightness and the solid color adjustment layers. I can also right-click on this layer mask of the brightness layer and delete it because I want to keep things clean and simple. And now let's make this shirt more bright by moving this slider to the right. Do not bring it to the maximum because that will look fake, but you can stop somewhere around here. You can also make the shadows darker by increasing the contrast, and then, if needed, you can lower the brightness just a bit. Now, if you want to make this very close to perfection, you need to do one more thing. I show you a cool trick, and then I teach you how to make this shirt black. So if you zoom in closely, you will see this black edge right here. I mean, it's not that noticeable, but a trained eye can see it, okay? So here is what you need to do to repair this. Select the solid color adjustment layer, Then hold down Ctrl and click on the new layer icon. This will create the layer under the current layer. This new layer has to be exactly here and not elsewhere. Now I can zoom in this area, grab the clone stamp tool, set a flow of 5%, sample from an area from the shirt, and then make your brush very soft. Now start brushing on the edge of the shirt, and you will see that slowly that black edge will fade away because you are filling it in with color from the shirt. So I will do this in all areas until that edge doesn't look weird anymore. I know it takes time. I know that some of you will say, "Hey Chris, but nobody will notice this." Well, I'm a perfectionist. This is a good thing and a bad thing in the same time, but this is who I am most of the time. Okay, so now just to let you see the small detail that makes the difference, check this out when I'm hiding and unhiding this layer. See that edge, how it disappears? I can choose whatever color I want now. Look at this. And the edge will always look good. And to make this shirt black, I use this same solid color adjustment layer. But instead of going pure black, which is unreal, I must choose a very dark gray. His pants are black, so I will have to find a similar color to that. This looks fine. I hit OK. And then I can control this even more by readjusting the brightness and the contrast sliders until I'm satisfied with the result. It's that easy. And now you know how to do it. If you like this tutorial, please press the thumbs up and feel free to watch another video from the screen. I'm Chris. Thanks a lot for watching and make sure you subscribe. Have a great day. Bye-bye now.